you're supportive of Japantown as a district. Couldn't be here right now, but I just wanted to let you know that the mayor and the council is aware of.
Good morning, Fuji Towers. Good morning to all of you. The project itself, of course, Fuji Towers, we will be reaching its milestone of 40 years come the end of the year, by January 2017. Our original 236 mortgage is going to be paid off, and then what do we do after that? We have, the board has discussed many issues regarding the future of Fuji Towers, and as I indicated to all of you in our first meeting, that the first question that came up at that meeting was, someone asked, will my rent go up? And at that point I said, don't worry about the rent, it's not going to change. Now, I hope I can live up to those words, because it's taken a lot more than I anticipated at the beginning. At that point, we had all of the issues somewhat lined up, and we thought this is going to be a piece of cake. Well, you know, when you're dealing with the federal government, it's not always that easy. Beginning in 2017, of course, we're going to be looking at a whole new scenario at Fuji Towers. It's going to be some major changes, and in order to accomplish all of these goals that we have set out to do, it has taken a tremendous amount of work amongst not just people at Fuji Towers, which is all of you, but we also have a big staff of people from outside of Fuji Towers that are providing us with information that we need, such as what's going to happen to the building. Well, as you know, a 40-year-old building is going to be, it's old, it's tired, there's a lot of replacements that have to be made. And so through the basic requirement that HUD asked us to do, we had a company come in and they did the assessment on the property, and we know that our basic infrastructure has to be updated, namely things like the elevator. We need to redo the sewer system, the electrical, you know, we also need to comply with the new ADA requirements, which is for handicap and wheelchair accessibility. All of these things that we need to do to bring the 1976 building to 2017 standards. So that in itself is going to, basic cost right now we think is around $4 million. The rest of what we want to do, and we've talked about it at our initial meeting, was we want to upgrade all of the rooms that all of you folks live in. We need to get those rooms updated with the modern equipment and the such. You know, we have so much to do to bring the building up to date that we're looking at an additional $10 million or more. And we have architects and contractors that are working on all of this for us to give us more specific numbers, but that's the general numbers that we're looking at right at this point. So without any more about the history, because this young lady that I'm going to introduce, she has a tremendous amount of knowledge about Fuji Towers. She was here initially when it went up, and she is a very strong supporter of our Japantown community, and it gives me a great deal of pleasure to introduce to all of you our District 16 Congressional District Representative, Congresswoman Zoe Laufer.
But here we are, and we have some challenges about Fuji. The first, of course, is to make sure that Fuji Towers continues to be a great home that's affordable for the current residents. That's the top of the line. The second thing is to make sure that it is safe. We need to make sure that all the health and safety issues are addressed, because we don't want people to live in an unsafe facility. Now, we had a chance to meet just a few days ago to try and map out what the issues are. We met with Warren, some of the experts that Fuji has retained to help on to deal with HUD. The head of the Housing Authority was there. Cindy Chavez, our Board of Supervisors member, was there, along with experts from the county, just to put our heads together to see what needs to be done. And one of the issues is to get these new approvals from HUD, to get new vouchers, so that there'll be a stream of funding that will help support the necessary improvements on the building. After that meeting, I called and spoke with Julian Castro, who is the Secretary of the Housing and Urban Development. And he told me that he knew about the towers, that he wanted to help, that he thought it would turn out well, and he pledged his help and support. I'm very encouraged by that, but there's a lot of details that have to happen yet. I know that your volunteer board is going to continue to help. I just want you to know I'll do everything I can to help. I see our friend Ash Kala, who's on the city council here. I know that Ash will do all he can. I did have a chance to speak with Mayor Liccardo briefly so that he would know about this. So if necessary, the city needs to step forward, they will do so. I'll just say that, you know, it's change also always makes us anxious. I understand that. And so that's why I wanted you to know that you're not alone here. We are going to all pull together. I know that Cindy Chavez, who's all on board on this, I don't think that Cindy was able to be here today. She's got another meeting, but her top staff person is here to fill her in, and we're all going to work together. I'm just going to apologize in advance. I have a scheduled call with the White House in about a half an hour, so before that I'm going to sneak out. But I have my chief of staff and a lawyer in my office who's working on this for me, and they will fill me in completely after I leave. And with that, just let me thank you for the great honor it's been to represent you in the Congress. I think about you all the time, and I'm certainly going to remember you as we go through this process. Thank you very much.
I want to just continue with our program for the day. And this is, again, talking about the project that we're going into. We are, as you've heard, we have applied for what is known as a RAD 2 program to take the place of our existing financing that we have. So what we need to do is, before the end of the year, or when January comes around, we want to terminate our present loan with HUD that is prepay the mortgage, and then hopefully we will be able to transition into the RAD 2. So that's our basic goal right now. There's some technicalities that need to be worked out, but with the help of our HUD office in San Francisco and all of the resources that we have, we think we're slowly getting the answers that we need so that we can complete the project. As I mentioned, the total cost of the entire project is going to be in excess of $10 million if we are able to get the funding to do the entire project. If and when we get the go-ahead, our contractors are looking at March of 2017 as the starting date to do the rehab of the building. And it's going to be done systematically. We have a relocation company on board with us, which means that those folks are going to inform the residents when their units are going to be worked on, so forth. So nobody is going to be inconvenienced. The only thing that's going to happen is, when your unit is being worked on, the relocation company will bring in their helpers to help pack all of your things, and they will then be put in storage, and you will be asked to just take what you need, and you're going to be relocated to the Holiday Inn on 4th Street. So you'll be living there for about 20 days at max. That's our relocation plan. So everything will be taken care of for you. You don't have to worry about anything. But when you come back, you should be in a brand new apartment. And that's our goal for each and every one of you. Now, the big work that's going to be done is on the ground floor. On the first floor, all of those units are now going to be converted to meet the requirements of the ADA law for handicapped residents. So that'll be one area of major work, and then all of the others will be done systematically with the help of our relocation company. So we have all of the necessary steps covered by either a outside company or through the Fuji Tower office. Everything will be taken care of so that we'll try not to inconvenience you as we go along. So this project will probably take through the end of 2017. So that's kind of a tentative calendar we're looking at. The important thing here is too that all of you will be notified 30 days in advance when it's going to be your time to take a vacation, to move over to the Holiday Inn. One nice thing over there at the Holiday Inn, they serve breakfast in the morning, so you don't have to make breakfast. You might have to cook for yourself in the evening. They have all of the units, I believe, are like kitchenettes, so you can cook if you want. So that's, and this is just advance information. You'll be getting more through our office from Francis on the details. Now, I want to just make a comment. The support that we have had from the community, it's amazing how all of the people that have come together to help Fuji Towers. I mean, for these people to come up and say, yes, we agree with what you're doing, we want to help you, and we'll support whatever you're doing. And our congresswoman has mentioned a few of them already, Cindy Chavez from the supervisor's office. We've had, and I see Kosh is here with us, he is not our district, not representative of District 3, which you live in, but I mean, he's one of these guys that supports the neighbors, and we appreciate that. We've met with your city councilman, Raul Perales' office, and he too has indicated that he would support us. We had a meeting here about 2 weeks ago with the Silicon Valley Leadership Group. Now, for most of you, this group probably doesn't mean anything. It didn't mean much to me until I met them. I mean, this is a very powerful group here in Silicon Valley. In fact, they had a meeting with Senator Dianne Feinstein yesterday, so they had told us when we left, we will support you. So I hope they put in a plug for us in that meeting. One of the original members of the Fuji Tower project at the time was Norman Mineta. He was the mayor of San Jose. He's since then gone on to Congress. He became the Secretary of Transportation, and he was here in San Jose about 3 weeks ago, and I had an opportunity to talk with him, and he said, sure, I'll be glad to support you. Whatever I can do to help move Fuji Towers, he said he would. In fact, he said, oh yes, I know Julian Castro very well. I'll give him a phone call. So, it's people like this that are telling everybody that Fuji Tower is important, and it's a place that we all are in agreement that we want to do the things that we are planning.
Sure, we're very excited to be here today to support Fuji Towers, and we've just brought a group from HUD to show our support. We have Gwen Kelleher, who is my supervisor, who's been very involved in this. Robin Thompson, Aaron Ferguson-Walth, and Amanda Kochak. And so again, we just wanted to show that we at HUD have had a 40-year partnership with Fuji Towers. You've done amazing work, and we're here to support you, hopefully for the next 40-plus years. So thank you.
Hi, good morning, everybody. I just wanted to let our residents know that we really appreciate all of the letters that came to my office, and we are actually very, very, very happy. We got 102 letters from each one of you.
However, the residents of Fuji Towers, we have to pay you.
So, we have submitted the protection voucher.
The question that she asked regarding might need some English interpretation or whatever sort of classroom. So if it's your card, we want to go turn it in.